I will break into you. I walk slowly through your trap, falling out of time, out of love, and out of my mind. I will be lonely.
Okay, so you guys are going to want to choose and contact the venues that you're looking at. So choosing a venue is kind of tricky as well. A lot of people think, oh, I'm going to call the music venue, the local music venue in the city, you know? And a lot of times as a solo artist coming out to these places, these music venues tend to be, you know, really heavily booked already. Sometimes they're not. Sometimes you can get in a really good place. You just got to try. You just have to try. It's not rocket science. You just got to give them a call. Tell them who you are, when you're the date you're going to be in town, and what you do. Send them a link, and you know, hopefully you get in. But essentially, what I found to be good for a solo artist is if you contact venues that don't usually have like huge shows. Essentially, what I'm talking about is what you want to do is you want to contact like bars and restaurants that have live entertainment. That aren't like music venues, you know what I'm saying? So if you're contacting like House of Blues or somewhere, you're less likely to get a show than if you call, you know, one of the local bars in the area that happens to be on one of the main drags with a lot of foot traffic. Let them know you're coming through, and you call a couple of those places. You know, if you're going to San Luis Obispo, you call, you know, two or three places, you know what I mean? And when I say call, I mean call. You call first. You don't email. And I'll give you an example here too. When I went on my last tour, I just sent out a kind of a generic email, you know, to everyone with some links to some of my stuff, and I didn't get any responses back. None. I literally got no responses back. Out of like 11 emails I sent out, I got no responses back. So I kept, you know, planning for the tour and doing other things and getting my accommodations, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm not getting anything back. Kind of followed up in another follow-up email, nothing back. So I finally just decided to just call. So one day I spent on the phone just calling all these places and getting and asking, oh, who, you know, hi, I'm Eddie Booz. I'm a, you know, touring act coming through in, you know, April or whatever. Can I speak with the person who books the music at this venue, please? You know, the manager on duty, or the person who books the music. And usually you're going to get through to the right person, or they'll tell you, oh, that's this person, and they'll be in at this time. Make sure you write it down. Make sure you get all the, make sure you, you know, notate everything. Get in contact with that person. Explain to them who you are and build yourself up. Tell them, a lot about yourself, and make yourself sound enticing. That make yourself sound like they want you at their venue, you know? And talk to them first. And then once you've talked to them, if they're interested, then you go ahead and send an email. You know what I mean? Send a couple links to your stuff. Let them know who you are. Let them know what you can do and what you're looking to do at their venue. Again, it's a lot. And something else too is it's a lot easier to book a night if you can play for two or three sets. If you can book 2 or 3 hours of entertainment, that way you don't have to have, they don't have to worry about booking opening acts, or they don't have to worry about anything else. They just, you come in, you fill the night, and that's it. Okay, so when I booked those shows, when I called all those venues, I ended up booking 9 out of the 11 shows in one day. So call first, and then email, then send the links. I'm going to be honest with you. A lot of people in different areas from where you are really looking for people that are, you know, putting their nose at a grindstone and coming out there and touring from different areas. That's something that bars and restaurants can really grab onto and promote. They say, hey, I got a guy that's coming out from LA, or I got a guy that's coming out from blah, 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 and he's going to be here in 2 months, and he's going to be playing. And then they promote your stuff. And that's how those shows get booked. I mean get like full, you know what I mean? Like I tell you, one of the shows I played on my last tour, I played in a place called Oxbow, Oregon, and it's a really small town. In fact, the place I played was called the Hell's Canyon Inn, and it's a really awesome little place on the 86 highway coming out of Baker going up towards Washington from Oregon. And I pulled in, it was like Thursday night. And they had me booked for like a month to 2 months before. So they knew I was coming, and they had my press kit. They had all my stuff with my poster and everything. So they put up posters in all of the surrounding towns saying, this guy's going to be at our place on this night. And it got enough people interested that they all went online and looked at my stuff and listened to my new album that had just come out. And when I showed up at that place on a Thursday night, I played at an outdoor amphitheater, probably 100 people capacity, and it was full. It was packed the entire time I played, 3 hours. And it was because the venue did their job. The venue took the press kit, you know, put it on the, you know, put it on the door, put it on the doors of all the local establishments around, and really promoted the show. So call first, then email second, and you guys will see a big success rate with that.